Hello everybody and welcome back to Viscera Cleanup Detail. I hope you won't mind that there is no break in between the two in my recording. I am recording these back to back. I'm going to try to finish this whole facility in one sitting despite multiple videos. And we will reconvene at the end and I will hopefully learn something from you guys, from the comments. Hopefully that won't just be that this is boring and I'm going to go watch TV now. So we've melted the body parts into smaller chunks throughout the facility. And we've gone through and we've basically cleaned up the information layer. There's some information left for us to get. We still have to count bullet holes. Yeah, you gotta count bullet holes. We also have to count bullet casings. And we'll have to come up with some kind of a guesstimate as to the number of dead scientists, aliens, and other in the facility. And we'll also have to piece together exactly what happened. So we'll get to that in more detail once I've mopped, but I can't mop yet because there's still a bunch of pieces of people laying around, and if I don't clean those up, it's only gonna get worse. So I'm gonna go through and clean up all the chunkies of the people. Fortunately, I went through a last video and we collected all of their USB sticks, and we documented their causes of death to the best of my ability. We also learned that small chunks of people make wonderful balls of goop that don't spread blood. Okay, so I probably will miss a intestinal chunk or some little thing here and there. But don't worry about that. They have tools for finding those things, and we will gain access to those as they become necessary. I don't think I'm going to be able to do anything about these little balls of goop. And note, I'm not... Ooh. I just realized there's mad feedback coming in. Whoops. I'm such an idiot. Guys, I was wearing my headphones, but they weren't plugged in. Who's the best? It's me. Holy, what the f... Your arm has a penis on it. God, that must make jerking off, like, really easy and handy. Oh, handy! Alright, so we're picking up the chunks. We're leaving the bullet casings, and I'm also... Actually... Alright, Strokey McGee, I'm gonna put you back. I forgot, we need to count the number of aliens. So I actually shouldn't pick up all the alien parts. There was a tentacle claw thing over there. I think this arm probably belongs to this alien. Let's count arms here. One. Does this one have a penis? No. It's one arm. That is maybe a shoulder. We got foot. Thigh things, foots. Yeah, okay, so that's this guy's arm. I'll just put this with him. And I'm also gonna guess that that was his, because I don't see him with a pokey spike. I'm assuming that this belonged to that guy. I don't recommend doing this, but... I'm just gonna put that down over there. So we'll just clean up the human chunks for now. Excuse me. Please, be a successful chunk. And go live in your home, the chunk bag. There's going to be a lot of chunks, and this is going to take a long time. So if you're waiting for the mopping, I'm sorry, it's probably going to happen either at the end of the video or somewhere around there. You should also know about how long this is going to take. We are about 40 minutes into this facility here, and... By my best estimate, I would say that we've got about 2 hours to go. So, to some of you, that's good news, because that's more videos. But if you're not fans of this series, then I'm sorry, but there's going to be a lot more of it. But don't worry, there will be other series, so if this isn't your bag, then just hang out and wait for the next one. I completely understand why some people would be totally turned off by this game and not have any interest in it whatsoever. Unfortunately, that will mean that I haven't been doing my job right, because my goal here is to try to get you to take a look at it anyway. But you can't always do the best or the correct job. Sometimes you have to do the job that you're capable of. Oh. I need to get this guy a jaw harp. I'm pretty sure that's the only instrument at this point that he could play. Hey, look! I found the jaw harp playing part. Now we just gotta find a jaw harp. Alright, gathering up the human pieces with general human shapes. You know, we need some polka. Where's the polka? Strung out orchestra? No. Cobbled hoppers? No. Red pill? No. Zoologists? Monkey fire? I don't remember which one is the polka one. Whoa, boy. The jungle one's good. Yeah. No. No. Come on. There it is. Cobble what? Cobble hoppers. Okay. This is my kind of music. So as we get further away from the radio, it'll get quieter and quieter. But it'll be a nice part of the atmosphere of the facility, the various polka effects we can get. I don't know. I may turn it off if it bothers me. But I do like me some polka. Just kicking it. Alright, I changed my mind. I'm not going to be ending up avoiding shitty puns. I'm going to embrace them. So, I know what you're saying. There's an incinerator right here, and you could just be throwing those parts in there. Yeah, but we're going to have to throw this bucket or barrel in there eventually anyway. So I might as well just save myself a few extra strokes of the old mouse bone. Put them in a containable area. Also, I kind of like to leave the various distributed body boxes. Whoops, wrong way. Just so I can dispose of them all in a kind of similar time frame. And it's not important when they go in there, as long as there's no huge chunks of bodies laying around before you start swanging your mop. Alright, no aliens. Not allowed. Okay, are there any pieces in here? Nope, not really, but I think, yes, right, there's this. That is a piece of something, and so is, oh boy. We've done it now. So over here is one of the cooler, actually, you know what? I might turn that off. I might actually go listen and see how loud that is, though, because it seems awfully loud to me. But then again, I'm the idiot that was wearing headphones without them plugged in. So what the hell do I know? Oh boy. Chunkies and chunkies and chunkies. Alright, I think that's all the human pieces in here for now, aside from the big ones. So this is our incinerator. Every level will have one, and it is how you dispose of the things that you do not want in your facility. Yeah, I'm good. Thank you for polka-ing with me, but yeah, that's actually kind of loud and irritating and dumb. It's got two sides. You can put things in there, and eventually they will burn. You can also fit body bags in here, which is why I've decided not to use the incinerator laser beam on them, because I could just do that instead, and similar effect. So what I'll do is I'll close this end of it. We'll stuff in as many bags as we can. Because I don't think that there's any way to get a bonus out of these body bags. So all they really are is a physics annoyance for the time being. They have to sit in the incinerator for a little while, and if you're having trouble getting them in there, as I am now, squish! That will take care of the rest. Alright, so I'm gonna leave the rest of these body bags for now, and we'll stick this guy right here where we can burn him up later. But you can see the effect that we're having. We're starting to reduce the amount of biological detritus for us to interact with in the environment. But we've got a long way to go yet, baby. Oh, good. Thanks, machine. I forgot to mention, or maybe I did kind of mention it. This is another reason that I went through and CSI'd all the bodies first. As you can see, I would now be very confused what the hell happened to this guy. Not that I was ever perfectly certain. All of the machines in Viscera Cleanup Detail have a chance to malfunction. This machine just malfunctioned and gave me a biohazard barrel. What it's normally supposed to do is print out a bunch of body chunks. Every once in a while, the bucket machine will accidentally produce a bucket, but most of the time it will just give you severed arms. They're trying to work out the kinks so that those machines only give you dead body parts and blood, but In the meantime, we'll just have to suffer through the occasional biohazard bucket and box and bucket of mop water. So I think we just have the autopsy room's body parts and the upstairs area here, plus, you know, this gentleman and his various pieces and components. I have, by the way, tried to reassemble a scientist and weld them back together with the various different parts. They didn't work, but I tried. Okay, so are you gonna malfunction again? Yes. The machine accidentally gave us this instead of body parts. Darn, we'll just have to keep on trying. In you go. Oh boy. Lots of fun noises. So this guy's not an alien, but he's also not a human, because he didn't have a USB stick, so he's not a member of the science team. So I don't really need to worry too much about how I categorize whatever he is or was, because I believe this was probably one of the experiment people, or experiment things. Here's one of the lights that you can get. You can get these dispensed from a dispenser machine, so you can have as many of them as you want, but they also are a bit dangerous and can explode. Here's another stacking area, by the way. I'll cover those soon, because they're not important right now. Alright, so let's toss you in here. So that's all of the goopy bits, aside from the body bags, on this floor. Let us make like Jaquan and move on to the next floor. Oh. Yeah, I said it. Ah, the glorious messes we make and clean. Okay. So, as for the other layers that I haven't described yet, we've obviously got to clean up the alien chunks next, but I think the next one after that will probably be bullet casings. Well, you know, we're going to have to mop first, and that's going to take a long time, but I'm looking forward to it because I do love me a good mop. And, I don't know if I'm going to be able to fit this guy in there. I do know that we're definitely going to need more of those bio buckets. In fact, we're going to need a bunch of biohazard containment buckets and water buckets to go on the elevator there. So, I think I'm just going to leave that whole thing up there. Kind of a little bit for now. Well, excuse me. Basically, I'm just going to load up the elevator with a bunch of biohazard buckets and water buckets. I know, no mopping yet, but we're going to need more than one of these. Also, one thing that you can do with this machine is if you know you're going to need a lot of these buckets like I do, you can just kind of keep thumping it and it will keep producing things. Of course, occasionally it will function correctly and quite well give you a bunch of body parts, but sometimes you will get these instead. Maybe this is enough, maybe it isn't. Maybe the world is not enough. Alright, well, it's gonna have to be enough for now. Whee! We'll do the bucket thing later. I thought I saw a USB stick, but it appears it was a bullet casing. Do we got the booty? He do! He definitely do. Okay, human remains. Remember, be respectful. Be respectful. Be respectful. Am I a cheerleader or am I a janitor? I mean, pom-poms and mops, like, they're the same thing, it's just that the stick is a lot shorter. That's a really weird way to look at things, but that makes it my favorite. Now, this guy's body that's in here should be a movable... Oh, yeah, right, we melted it, so I don't have to worry about it. Way to go, me! I can just toss this guy over there for now. Did I make a big mess? No, I made a mess, but not a big one. You go being all dramatic on me, bucket of slop. High five. High five. And a one. And a booty. And a footy. Never mind. That's the torso that we melted. Get in there. This, I should have definitely melted all of the alien chunks. Also, I haven't counted them. Why am I bagging them up? You represent one alien. I think this is just one alien that was up here, though, so I'm not too concerned about it. One of his arms was over there, but the rest of him was over there, and there was no other alien stuff in here, aside from the head crab, which may count. So, yeah, I guess I will finish bagging him up, and then we'll go through and get the other aliens and count them out. I think there's only, like, three aliens here, though. When you gotta go, you gotta go. I want you to get out of there. Was his hand always in there? Maybe he was, like, digging around for something in there. This, by the way, this water, once water in a toilet becomes bloody, it's bloody forever. You can, however, if your mop is bloody, clean it, like so, but eventually you will just turn the toilet into a bloody toilet. Alright, so now we're counting the alien corpses. We've got all the human chunks boxed up, so I remember this was one alien up here. Its cause of death is irrelevant. We know what its cause of death was. It was killed by the guy sent to clean this facility out of aliens before we got here. A dedicated alien killer, if you will. I'm just going to take this. I might as well take the rest, too. If I'm going to take a huge ball of meat, I might as well take a bunch of boxes of meat. Plus, something amusing will happen when we go down and we inevitably hit the physics bump that is waiting for us. I hope I didn't accidentally put any bullet casings in here. Oh, physics. This is gonna be fun. Lots and lots. Oh. Alright, come on. It's the butt. Don't fall out, butt. Lots and lots of disconnected physics-enabled pieces in small containers are about to go on an elevator ride together at the same time. What could possibly go wrong? Video game physics are never wrong. Excuse me, I'm the janitor I need to get through. I see you, intestine. Thought you could sneak past me. Oh no! I'm too crafty. Been in this job a few fair years. Boing! Everybody still in? Everybody still in? Alright, we're good. Okay. So I'm just gonna leave all of this stuff right here, right now. It will eventually get incinerated, but is not important at the moment. Everybody wave your hand in the air like you just don't have any of the rest of your body and are actually a severed hand. And don't care. Okay. Biological goopy bits upstairs are done. Now let's just go gather up the rest of the aliens. We know the current alien count is set to the inauspicious amount of one. Let's see if we can drive that number up through the roof, which is probably on fire. So this makes two. He's shocked. He's absolutely shocked. I'm an alien? Whoa. Wow, his head is super heavy. It turned the bucket into one of those fucking inflatable clowns with sand at the bottom. That's a really hard thing to describe in a small amount of words. You know those, you would punch the clown, the inflatable clown, and it would come right back up at you? It was in Ninja Turtles 2. Donatello got into a fight with one. You know these things. Come on. Oh no, this is the proboscis hand. Alright, I'm gonna pretend like all of these chunks have been accounted for. They haven't. We need to go get more bodies. Mm-hmm. By the way, if you like first-person shooters and you like tight movement controls, this game has them, but it doesn't have things like air movement, air strafing, or any way to increase your movement speed through the use of hops. So I will try not to do that, although it is fun. Initially, I thought that the movement was similar to CSGO or something like that, where... Or, you know, any CS, but where you could do move strafing and things. But you actually can't. Once you enter the air, your trajectory is determined and cannot be altered. Alright. Two aliens. And one, I think there's only one left, and it was in the Save Us room, which I believe is the infirmary, but I can check the label on it. The ward. Well, that's just semantics. Alright, so you are number three. You're very vocal with your squishiness, and I don't appreciate that. Please, sir, I'm trying to record a video here. Could your body parts be less loud? I'm gonna need another bucket. Just for this one dude. Well, you know, you never know. The arm is saying dude, but everything else. Hey! Nice job, machine. Oh, I broke it. Basically, well, I have my own method for dealing with the malfunctions of the machines, and I will go over that when the time is right, but it is not now. We're still getting body parts. But this should be... Please, no. It should be the last bunch of them. Now, it could be something, like, very simple that I just don't understand about the alien counts. There could be the green body bags are aliens, and the white ones are scientists, and I need to count those two or something, but I don't know, so I'm gonna pretend that it's irrelevant and it doesn't matter, and I'm gonna assume that those are not part of the deal. I see you there. One thing I can do is I can use the mop as a whacking tool. That's the official name. Come on. And we're gonna have to try again. There we go. You can't crouch, to my knowledge, in the game, which is kind of an oversight because of things like this. But there we go. Nope. Okay. That looks solid. Speaking of solid, there's these things, and somebody missed a spot. just one? No. I'm sure that we'll find more instances of forgotten remains unpicked up as we go. It doesn't matter that I get every single one, but what does matter is that when we start mopping the bloody areas, we're not going to be accidentally spreading more goop. Usually. Alright, so... all's well there. Now we can finish the... well, we can't actually finish the information layer. What we can do is we can start. We can go next, count up all the bullet casings. So we've got the aliens, number of aliens. Three. But the next thing we're going to have to do is figure out how many bullet casings were spent. And the way I like to do that is to count them as I pick them up in a bucket. It's a little difficult to do before you mop, though, as you can see. And it's even more difficult to do after you mop, because mopping will move the bullet casings all over the place. Plus, it's impossible to count bullet holes before you mop, because many of them are just simply going to be covered up by blood stains. So I think what we will do is we will save the bullet casings until after the blood. I don't think I normally do that, but I'm going to do that here. So when you want to start mopping, we'll deal with all the rest of this various detritus cluttering up the hallways. When you want to start mopping, you're going to need a bucket. But this machine, like the What a Load dispenser over there, occasionally produces things other than buckets. I mean, it occasionally produces... excuse me, what? There's a note here? Oh, hey, STD and I remember we picked him up. I think I might have... I've been asked again to reinforce cell doors. I really don't see the point. They're strong enough. I mean, what could possibly get through those? Got more important jobs anyway. Okay. I'll add that to the rest of our documentation. You're going to want to leave a bucket near the bucket dispenser and a biohazard container near the bucket dispenser. And you're going to want to leave a bucket and a biohazard dispenser next to, or container, next to this thing. So, thank you. We're going to need to keep using this after we've mopped, so we need to make sure that we have the ability to clean up the various pieces of gunk and blood stuff that come out of it. That's why I'm leaving a bucket here. This is the What a Load's personal bucket. And this container now is the Slosh-O-Matic's personal biohazard container. And this is the Slosh-O-Matic's personal bucket. Every other bucket that we get here is going to be used for mopping, but this is going to happen sometimes. And that's why we have... This is why we mop last. Please? Okay. I don't know if there's any rhyme or reason to why the dispenser does what it does, the way it does, and when it does, or if there's any way to avoid or encourage, or etc. the thing. So I'm leaving a trail of buckets here leading towards the incinerator. That's our first target. So let's get started. And mop, mop, mop. Oh, shit. You gotta be a little careful with the buckets in the game, too. They have their own interesting physics opportunities and pitfalls. So let's get all the blood off of us. If you look at my hands here, you'll see that there's a little bit of red on them. That's sort of how much blood I'm carrying with me. But as I walk... Oh, I guess that's probably because of what's on the mop. As I become more clean and have less blood on my feet and around me... I should focus, by the way, on just the floors initially here. But I'm mostly trying to get my way to the incinerator as well. But as I get more clean and my area gets more clean, the blood on the gloves and goop on you and the amount of noise that you make when you splatter around the station will decrease, and that's nice. So why go to the incinerator first? Because that's the only way to get rid of a bucket full of blood, is to incinerate it. And if you go anywhere else first, you'll end up dropping and kicking over buckets full of blood all over the place. I'm gonna move this into a more obvious location so that I can hopefully find it later. So this is what the mopping is primarily like. And you can see these footprints, they come up really quickly, and they don't comprise too much of a problem for us. Obviously, there'd be less blood if there were less footprints. But I think it's a pretty minuscule amount for the amount of information that we were able to get. And I think it's, in the end, worth it to avoid the various, trials and pitfalls associated with trying to prematurely mop. I like to only mop when the time is right. So you gotta treat your mop like an ambush. You have to sneak up on the blood when it's least expecting it. Uah! There, see? Didn't even have a chance to run away. Alright, so we've basically accomplished what we needed to here. Any bucket that needs to be disposed of can be. And I think this one is probably also full, but I'll find out. You don't have to move the buckets one by one, but the physics are interesting. I will try to show you guys a cool science experiment involving buckets, but no promises. Jeff, why don't you incinerate the containers full of body parts before mopping? Well, I'm an idiot and a hypocrite. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you enjoy it here. So we've cleaned our way to the incinerator, and basically now the world is our oyster. Anywhere that we want to go in the facility, all we got to do is make sure that we've got a mop nearby, and we can start going through and cleaning up all the blood. There are a few different ways you can find all the various different blood and blood splats, but the easiest way is to just look for them on the ground and on the walls and mop them up. There are some that you're not going to be able to see, though. They'll be the same color as the wall, or covered up by some burn mark or ashes or something like that. And so you simply won't be able to see those. That's where the sniffer comes in. There's no point using the sniffer right now. It'll detect everything. But I will show it to you later, and that is one of the tools that we're going to use to try to get 100%. After the mopping is done, I can explain the stacking areas to you, and show you how they work. But this, my friends, this is the heart and the soul of the viscera cleanup detail. And it's also one of the most satisfying parts, too. Just cleaning up this one room is going to make me so happy every time I walk into it. And, you know, people ask me when I first started talking about the series, or whenever I stream the thing, it's like, why do you like cleaning? It's not that I like cleaning. I think everybody in life has to clean, right? It's part of life. It's not... I've had jobs before where I've had to clean, specifically. But also, you know, it's just part of life. Part of what you, you know, have to do as a human. I guess if you have a butler, then yeah, that's a valid question. Why the hell do you like to clean? Well, I don't have a butler. And so, you know, one of the things that you do is you sort of generate your own cleaning strategies and ways to entertain yourself and the kind of enjoyment that you can get out of both living in a clean, orderly environment, which is good, and the therapeutic benefit of putting in a good day's work. But the problem is that people are going to possibly assume that because I am willing to, for entertainment, clean something very dirty, they might assume that I seek out cleanliness and try to keep all things in my life clean at all times, but that's not true at all. And I think that's one of the reasons why I like Viscera Cleanup Detail so much, is that it fits my style of cleaning. And my style of cleaning is to let it get this bad and then do it all at once. And so I don't recommend that. I think that's a pretty shitty way to go through life and to keep your, you know, house. But that's how I do it. And it fits perfectly with Viscera Cleanup Detail, because everything's already done. And then I don't have to clean again. That's the thing. I don't mind cleaning, I just don't want to do it again right away. You know what I mean? No, you don't know what I mean. You have a butler. I hope his name is Clarence, and he treats you right. Give him a tip for me. There's one of those pieces I warned you about, spreading the goop and goop stuffs. Alright, you don't get your bucket anymore, you can always make a new one. You saw I did stack a couple of buckets there. It's not something that I think is the smartest thing to do, but I was in a hurry. So I could go get the ladder thing, or I could just try to get up on this. Is that gonna work for me? No. You know what might work? What about... Uh-oh. Did I just discover... Did I just discover how to go surfing? Hang on a minute. This is a terrible idea, but... That was sweet. Can I do it again? Oh my god! Yes, I've discovered how to go surfing. Good to know. Please don't fall over. Okay. Good to know, but not why we're here. For now. Maybe that will become our objective later. Alright, this'll do it. If I can... By the way, that little stuttery frame lag thing you saw there was probably the game auto-saving. It does that from time to time. I consider it to be a nice thing. Neat thing about buckets, by the way, they work like stepladders. You don't have to do anything. You'll just step up on top of them automatically. You don't have to jump. So if you're having a really hard time getting a little bit of extra altitude, you can use a bucket. And we're here. Fortunately, I don't see any body parts or bullet holes up here. So this should be a pretty straightforward swack it with a mop and get on out of here. Alright. Bingo. Getting warmer. I somehow managed to goop the shoes. Way to go, me. Oh. That's a fourth alien. I did not count or dispose of its body parts. Somebody missed a spot. Worst guy ever. Wow. You really went for the gusto here, didn't you? Okay. Please don't do what physics indicates to you you should want to do. Okay. Good. The buckets, the spilling of water and such with buckets is a little weird. You can spill the water. You can see it sort of tilting. The gravity is not really simulated. This is using the Unreal Engine, so it's not super complicated, but... Please, why? Bed machine. Bed machine and make a bloody part I do not like. Oh, scientists, why do you have to have so much blood in you? Hopefully at some point, I will encounter the rare but exciting Mobius bucket. I don't want to say too much, but it's difficult to reproduce, but incredibly interesting. Is that? I don't think that's a thing up there. I'll have to check the other rooms to see. Sometimes facilities will have little hidden kind of hatch covers and stuff. Like, that sort of looks like one. Usually, if you whack it with your mop, if it is, you will be notified by the sound of crashing metal. So this will carry some of those monster parts. I hope I didn't count this one twice. I don't think I did. Pretty sure he's number 4. I'm not counting the headcrab also. So yeah, we're gonna be potentially way off. Who's shocked? No one. I know, walking through blood. I learned a long time ago, it's already empty, to stop fearing spreading blood and to learn to embrace the mop. And got your proboscis arm. It is embedded in his own wrist. Gross. Son, you done fucked yourself. Nice job. Chaos dunk. These things don't need to be stacked particularly well. I may be able to get a second one in there if I do it like that. Uh-oh. I thought it was closed on this end. Smart. Okay, I know we made a little bit more of a mess, because again, this is all because I missed body parts, and if you do it right, using the biological layer method, I do believe that you will find it to be efficient and successful at limiting the spread of goop, while also maintaining the kind of information you're going to need to get a 100% score. And remember, that is our goal here. It's not just to not get fired. We want to be Employee of the Month 7 times on the journey to find what happened to Bob. There was a bucket over here at some point, but I think I... Here it is. I've discovered the secret bucket. The secret of the magic bucket. Spreading blood and mopping blood are remarkably close to one another. Alright, and those were mostly ashes there. Okie dokie. This room is very close to being completely and totally clean. And this will be an example, a little, you know, a case study, a test thing, a proof of concept that one can, given a mop, a bucket, and a garbage can, or incinerator in this case, successfully clean basically anything. So there you have it. Room numero uno is done with blood. There's things in here that we still have to do. Anyway, like I said, let me check it out. Totally clean, not a single drop of blood. And all we gotta do is do that to everything else. So, if you've made it this far, I don't have to ask you to join me next time with me, 1F Me.